IRC news is good like a pal. I'm making the intro.
Then EFNet news. It's the motherfucking dopest IRC news show. Also, Dab Guy is a piece of shit. He'll never be able to follow through with his own news show. Boom. Gang.
Wireless, so I never gotta plug it in. Wireless, never plugging in my phone again. Wireless, so I never gotta plug it in. Wireless, never gonna plug my phone again. Never, 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 bitch, never, never.
This is EFNet News. Listen back. We deliver the latest and greatest from Ellis Free Network.
Fucking newscast, man.
I'm aware of the podcast.
EFNet News Podcast.
This is ENN, the Penis Pump Broadcasting Company.
Yo, what up, everybody? It's motherfucking episode 150. We made it. EFNet News. You know what I'm saying? I'm Jason Bandy. I am surprised that we hit 150, but here we are. We did it. All of us together. We did it together. If you're watching this episode, that means that you contributed to me continuing to do this because you showed interest and you kept this shit moving. Keeping EFNet great again, or IRC great again, you know what I'm saying? You got the media people like myself. We got people like Load with the Load Radio Hour. We've got Eraser. We've got rappers and shit like Jewbird and Dark Mage. And, you know, loads of people. I don't know who else fucking... God, I'm sure I'm forgetting people like Spoke, you know, that were doing media and the drawers, the ASCII artists and shit like that. But I didn't really come prepared for this. I should have written something down. But anyway, if you're a media person, if you like to make content that's IRC related, you're continuing to help IRC thrive in this dying social experiment. So I will start out by saying a shout out to Sayjay's dog, Vincent, who is a rescue dog. Apparently Vincent had to have ear canal ablation surgery, which I've never even heard of, and it was saved from being killed. So again, shout out to Vincent. I love shouting out the pets, so if you have one, let me know and I'll definitely put him on the show. Speaking of Sayjay, some of you may or may not know, but after fucking Load, she went and fucked Meep Sheep. So they're like Snowball Buddies, I think it's called, or Snowball Twins. Now, of course, there's some weird bro code issues there because of how close Meep Sheep and Load are, but I'm not really privy to all that. Maybe it's all good, maybe it's not, I don't know. What I am aware of is that a horny Meep Sheep was chatting recently because he said, "I want to cuddle Sayjay again, soon." Word up, Meep Sheep. Way to keep it real in the chats. I wonder which chatter will be the next to fuck Sayjay. Will it be Meep Sheep? Maybe Jewbird, because he's been getting his fuck on. But of course, Sayjay doesn't wear a hijab, or however you say it. So I don't know if Jewbird will be interested in that. And yeah, maybe Dark Mage. Again, I don't know. An old school packet kid, or probably a packet parent by now, stuck his head in Pound EFNet recently and looked for some other old packet parents, Neary and Haddam. Lost Bit hadn't seen him though, and Sir's connection was closed. So look at that there. If you were on IRC like 10 years ago, or you probably know all three of those Nicks, but I bet Pound EFNet hopes that they remain unseen for quite a long time. Jewbird said something pretty odd recently. He said, damn, I'd face fuck Greta so hard. That, of course, being Greta, the one that keeps pushing for climate change and stuff like that. Thornburg, I think it is. I then exclaim my wow. Jira says gross. Stratum says whoa. It looks like he's competing with Darn for being the most into having sex with Greta Thornburg, who is legal, I think. But you got to be a sick fucker to be attracted to someone like that. That's literally undeveloped. He could have been joking. In fact, he may have said he was joking a couple lines after that log, but I'm not going to include that in this story. Ah, yeah, Jewbird. Ah, you like that? So I dropped an alias that Luldong said a long time ago. It reads, nice, I got one more paycheck from the last job than I was expecting. Nice way to start a day. I love that alias because it gets so many people. You can look at the log here. What I didn't expect was to troll one of the people that claims to have started online trolling, the great Incog. But because he's such a stand-up guy, he just admits to it and moved right along. I encourage you all to start using that alias, or just more aliases in general. It makes IRC fun and unpredictable, and it actually predates memes. It's like IRC memes. So I made a fuck up a few episodes ago, and Newline, shout out to Newline over in Pound Stress, let me know that I'd made that fuck up. He said, Vapor, you got the wrong log for the IRC dot kick. So when reporting on a racer fucking up trying to kick somebody, I actually used the wrong log image. So I guess it was a fuck-upception. Thanks to New Line for pointing that out. And I do apologize for the amount that I'm having to go like that and belch quietly. I just ate like 4 rice cakes with peanut butter on. I wanted to only eat one, but then I ate another one. And then I ate another one. And then I ate another one. That's a rice cake-ception. Just wanted to apologize to the viewers and to Psymaster. My life's been a bit weird right now. I never know when I can record, so it's tough to give him notice for the weather. I did let him know about 9 hours ago, but he's been asleep or idle. I don't know. Anyway, again, sorry for that. Luckily, now I didn't do anything special for this episode, but somebody special came through with a segment with only an hour's notice that I was going to record so quickly this week. So let's hear what a racer has to say about Sub-Ohm's desk.
Chatters and top chatters alike, salome and salutations. Welcome to the Eraser Desk Review and Commentary Corner. Now, if you would like to submit your desk picks to me to review and commentate on weekly, send them via email, Twitter, query on IRC, Christian Mingle, Grindr, wherever you can find me, send me them pictures, and I'll be sure to slide you in and tell the world what I really think about you and your desk. Now, let's get right into this week's submission from Sub-Ohm. Actually, it wasn't really a submission. He just put it out into LRH, and I took it and decided to commentate on it, because why not? Other people's desks have been commentating on. Let's start with Sub-Ohm this week, you know? Now, I want to give a trigger warning. There's a lot going on this desk, so we're going to dissect it slowly but methodically so that you're not so overwhelmed, okay? Let's dive right in. Whoa, okay. Now, there's a lot going on here, like I said. There's a lot in the foreground and a lot in the background. But what actually catches me off guard here is the widescreen. Now, this could be because of the angle. It might be a MySpace angle. But that widescreen looks exceptionally wide. It looks like something you would find possibly on the Starship Enterprise. I'm not really sure. Now, what you can see is, obviously, Sub-Ohm is living vicariously through a trucking simulator. Maybe he is a trucking person IRL, but I hope he isn't, because he chats a lot, and if he's driving an 18-wheeler chatting that much, accidents will happen, of course, but seems like he's going to kill somebody. But look at the steering wheel, too. The steering wheel looks like it may have been custom wrapped. I'm not sure if it actually came that way, or if Sub-Ohm wrapped it himself, or possibly send it out to a trucking simulator steering wheel wrapping pro. Very interesting. Now, we got a couple other things on this desk. We got a, looks like a Target gift card. Looks like a small bottle, which might be steroids. I'm not really 100% positive. Nice little coffee cup. Goes with the aesthetic of the rest of the desk. Very nice. A little tin of, I don't know if that's chewing tobacco or possibly joint and muscle rub, because when you're steering, you know, you gotta keep them joints loose. It could possibly be a heating salve or something like that to keep the muscles and joints loose for proper steering. You don't want to hit nothing in your trucking simulator, you understand? Now, the most important thing that I think, the most important and interesting thing, let's check out the left corner over here. This is Subohm seriously living the trucker lifestyle. Whether IRL or behind a trucking simulator, he's really going for the desired effect of living like a trucker with this huge bottle of caffeine pills. It even has like the molecular breakdown up in there. That's impressive. I mean, if you're going to be a trucker, caffeine is most certainly one of those things that you're going to be intaking quite substantially. Other comments about the desk? I don't know. The blinds, they're nice blinds. They're white. Can't go wrong with white. And then you got a backlit keyboard, something, you know, that, you know, rich bougie people are rocking that I don't, you know, a person of my stature can't afford, but more power to them. I'd like to see a little bit better wire management on this one. Kind of scraggly and unkept, and kind of reminds me of like LeBron James's hairline. But other than that, it's a pretty good desk. Actually, the desk itself, if you look at the wood grain or whatever that is, the composite, looks very clean. Just the wires and the shit on top needs a little bit fine tuning. Well, that's it for this week. I hope you do submit your pictures to me so I can review your desk. I promise I won't be mean. I could have been mean to Subohm, but I'm not going to be mean. It's just a nice desk. Let's talk about desks, people. Submit your desk pics. I'll see you next week. Back to you, Jason.
Goddamn. Every time a racer does a segment, it makes me want to quit my job and give this shit over to him. He's so funny. Love the little scrolling letters, too. And you're right. Can't go wrong with white. Just kidding. Actually, you're right. Subohm, man, I had no idea you were into trucking. That's very interesting. I'd love to know more about that. Hopefully tune in next week where hopefully, I can't promise anything, but hopefully a racer will review VXP or Arab or Roar's desk, which we got to see today. Goddamn rice cakes and peanut butter. We got to see it today and it was surprisingly unique. So anyway, you'll have to tune in for that next week. And thank you again, Eraser. That was beautiful, especially short notice. I love the zoom in on the wood grain. right, so here's a philosophical question from 2019's Chatter of the Year. Darn asked, do you ever meet people in IRC that are such a wasted soul that the only benefit to mankind you can think of or they would serve is that you would just kill them and use their skin for clothing? Well, yeah, I hear you. Some of these people are such waste that I wouldn't even wear their skin, darn. But I do know what you mean. Perhaps you could make like some kind of skin jerky out of some of these guys. Speaking of skin jerky and just people I don't like very much, Racer made a pretty loaded request recently, almost like a birthday or Christmas present, and it was instantly delivered. He said, can someone please just kill Perplexa because of his belt? Just one time. Thanks. And Steve-U, bam, killed him and said your belt is gay. Fucking awesome. Now, if you haven't seen that belt, we showed it before. There's been askies made. Check out the length. I'll leave it up there. Look down. Look at that. That's just amazing. It's like a size 38 belt and a size 26 waist. Here's some Dwaine quotes for you. Him saying, anyone that disses Anji answers to the Lord. And all about girth, not the pole size. So there you go. I gotta agree with the Anji one there. Don't diss Anji. And now some interesting info from Darn, who some of you may or may not know, is confined to a wheelchair. He said, my friend showed me my legs could work. He hit it with a taser and it jumped. And then at the bottom, he says it made a burning smell though. So may have done some damage, Darn. Monochrome got huge cocked recently. So Alaska-B said, sup. Monochrome then went in saying, work, kinda. This week's weird because transitioning to a new product. So to be honest, Googling Pokemon. Hell yeah, shot Pokemon. Said, LOL, Kakama, are you doing better? Or Kakama, however you say it. Sup with you, Alaska-B. Meanwhile, that whole time, it was just huge cock. ET also got huge cocked. Hugecock's Nick was you at the time, said, what's everyone listening to? And he said, Sonic Youth, Sugarcane. Again, you're just talking to bots out there in FNet News. It's a wasteland. Now, here's an interesting one. We got in /join over on Freenode. We got two people get in Gaydog at once. So, for those of you who don't know, Gaydog greets the person and tricks them into replying. So, we got a Brazilian named Yorox that joined. He's asked, how are you today? Yorox says, hi. Gaydog says, I don't want to hear it, my fellow gay friend. Yorox says, you motherfucker. And does a .udp flood. Randons, fucked. Now, as he's saying that, Danger joins. Yorox leaves. Danger gets greeted. He does a dot user. He gets called gay. He says, you're a motherfucking nice gay man for not knowing how to join a channel, you pal. Please kiss me. And he says, ol sabim kolaka bot. Danger slaps Danger around a bit with a large trout. So he slaps himself and then leaves the channel. So that was a pretty good interaction there. Someone named Lil Chan joins. He gets greeted. He says, fine. Who are you, gay dog? With a smile. Gay dog says, I don't want to hear it, my fellow gay friend. He says, how did you know? Gay dog says, you're a motherfucking nice gay man. And Lulshin says, feeling a bit embarrassed, and leaves. So that's the first time, this is a Hungarian there, first time I've ever seen anyone admit to actually being gay when they join the channel. So that's pretty cool. It's storming hard as fuck. I had to stop it there because it got so loud. So hopefully it didn't interrupt the cast too much. But we'll go on to the next story. This one's interesting. Jewbird, who's been talking a lot about his sexual conquest lately. He said, now, whenever I chat to Muslim girls, I just think they all got a click cut. Logic says, woo, serious? How is that? Jewbird says, I asked all the ones I knew if they got their click cut, and they said, yeah, when they were a baby. It's a common thing here. Logic says, damn, what's the excuse they use it for culturally? I guess I made that sound weird. He said, what is the excuse they use it for culturally? Jewbird says, yeah, culture, tradition, ritual. Logic says, I guess, though, they let you stick your head up their asses, so it works out in the end. I guess he means that they have anal sex. Jewbird says, I think something like 80% of girls under 11 here have had it done. Big problem here in Indonesia. But on the bright side, only 30 Australian dollars a month for fiber to home internet. That's like a fucking Norm MacDonald joke right there. Jesus Christ. Yeah, good plus side there. Not bad. Wonder what kind of speed you get. But yeah, sucks for all that click cut. That'd be a good nickname on IRC. So, let's see what we got here. Diesel, the ass fingerer, got his vanity on. I thought this was funny. You can see where his original host was bnc1.ircnow.org. And he had it changed to tacbar.bnc.ircnow.org. So he actually took the time to get that edited. Probably had to submit a form or set it himself, which to me, I don't know, that just seems a bit weird. But he did get his nick back, so that's good. By the way, this is by far the out of context quote of the week. Dwaine saying, love to molest kids. So fucking hell, that's exactly why we have this out of context quote of the week thing. So, Bracket K Bracket and Port 80 suggested I just scroll the patron names as I wrap up. Do you have any opinion on this? Do you support the show just so you can hear me say your name and then fap to it later? Or are you fapping now? Please let me know in Pound FNet News or in private message if you have an opinion. I don't want to deprive you of a nice orgasm celebrating my voice. Or maybe you got used to the rhythm of me reading the names or like it when I fuck them up. Who knows? I know that Lily used to like it when I fucked her name up. But, you know, she's not on there anymore. Maybe she'll sign up just to hear me fuck it up again, and I won't do the scroll thing. I'll do the reading the names thing like I used to do. Who knows? Anything can happen at this point. But anyway, let me know what you think about that instead of reading the names. It feels kind of weird not to read the names. So I'll be glad to switch it back if needed. But anyway, this has been episode 150 of FNet News. I am Jason Bandy, and I hope you've enjoyed 150 fucking episodes of this show. You know, I've enjoyed making them for you. And here's to another 10 or so. Peace.
For more EFNet News, follow Vapor on Snapchat as Smiggy999 or on Twitter as PP4L.
the round me are the world like roses. I see users, fucking pieces of trash. Dab guy. Dab.